Hello everyone, this is Jyothi Bedi from the Heritage City of Mysore, the cultural capital of Karnataka, winner of IAWA Mrs. India 2020 Classic and now delegate of IAWA Popular Queen of Universe 2020. Today we are going to talk about mental health and awareness. Women since ages have been mentally suppressed by her male counterparts of the society. She has been curbed on the freedom to speech, expression and movement. The suppression for a long time has led to mental illness. If a parent in a house is mentally ill and he or she is a control freak or a conservative, we can imagine how a growth of the child would be in such atmosphere. As long as they are under the control of their parents, they might listen to their parents. But once they are free, they might try to do their own ways by doing, exploring and experimenting in their own way. Who is to blame for it? It is us, we the society. We are in such a conservative society where kids are taught not to ask questions to elders or teachers. But this trend is now recently changing. When any person has a doubt and his question is not answered, he tries to find answer in his own ways. All this is leading to mental illness. And that's why crime rate is also increasing so rapidly on women and girls also. Admission of the general public to their feelings towards people with mental illness again indicates the prevalent stigma in the society. Stigma and awareness are two separate issues, although interlinked. They need to be addressed in parallel in order to tackle the burden of mental illness in India. If individuals continue to view mental illness with apprehension and resistance, it will remain difficult for people with mental health concerns to seek the support they require due to the fear of being labeled or judged. The need of the hour is to sensitize and educate individuals about the signs and symptoms of mental illness while normalizing the idea of seeking support for themselves and their loved ones. There needs to be more open discussion and dialogue with the general public. Mental health and domestic violence is somewhat interlinked. So, what is the protection for women under domestic violence? The Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act 2005 gives laws and protection for women under domestic violence. Also, woman or a girl child is equally entitled to inherit property from her father or from the ancestral property. Also, if a woman is divorced and her husband is not giving maintenance, then she can file case against her husband for maintenance, seeking maintenance for herself and for her children. The law has given many remedies to women under distress, but the common woman, as she does not know or she is not aware of the laws, she is not able to take or make proper use of it. Creating awareness is also very important. Education, proper guidance, awareness go a long way in giving justice to the victims of this domestic abuse or violence. Thanks for watching.